When we seek understanding, based on the premise that men have corrupted the word of God so that they might rob us of our hope and strength, and have hidden from us the knowledge that the word is written in the stars, the result for the unbiased inquirer will be a clear perception of the end times. The Most High has not asked us to believe in fairy tales, and I will show wonders in heaven above and signs in the earth beneath. And when prophecy is about to be fulfilled, signs in heaven align with signs on earth. For example, the Bible teaches that two witnesses will come, and I will give power unto my two witnesses, and they shall prophesy 1,260 days, clothed in sackcloth. 4. These are the two olive trees, and the two candlesticks standing before the God of the earth. Revelation 11, 3, 4. Never once did the Bible tell us that two men would come before the two witnesses who are Elijah and Moses, but the word does say there would be signs in the earth, and the testimony of these two men would confirm the existence and work of the Messiah and give us insight into the powers that will be displayed by the 144,000. Simon Kimbangu was born in Congo Free State in 1887. He was a prophet. He healed the sick, made the lame walk, returned sight to the blind and hearing to the deaf, and even brought back to life an infant who had been dead for 3 days. He prophesied the end of Gentile oppression in Africa, which is in line with Bible prophecies. He announced that the colonial authorities were about to arrest him and impose a long period of silence on my body. His ministry lasted only 5 months. He died in prison in 1951 after 30 years of incarceration. The Catholic and Belgian authorities were offended because Simeon Kimbangu was a living witness that the Messiah was born of a woman in Africa and walked in the power of the kingdom of God. They were outraged that after thousands of years of debates arguing for and against the Messiah's existence and presenting a false physical identity, that in a moment God had exposed the lies of his enemies and reminded them of their looming destruction. The second witness is Simon Toko. Born in 1918 in northern Angola, he began preaching and performing miracles after moving to the Congo. His first public prayer was a call on the Holy Spirit to end the abuses of the colonial powers in Africa. As a result of this, the Belgian authorities arrested Simon and deported him back to Angola. But before he left, he gave those Belgians a warning. He gave them 10 years to leave the Congo. And 10 years later, in 1960, Simon Toko unleashed an army of 1,000 angelic beings with supernatural powers on the Belgian army and sent those soldiers running for their lives. Upon his return to Angola, the Portuguese colonial powers engaged in many attempts to kill Simon. In one attempt, they told him to clean the blades of a grass-cutting tractor, then switched on the blades. His body was severed, then miraculously reconstructed itself. When the Portuguese witnessed this, they ran away in fear. The Catholic Church was so afraid that they could not just kill him as they killed Christ. The Pope sent emissaries to ask him who he was. His reply was Matthew 11, 2-6, when Jesus sent word to John of the miracles he had performed. The Pope wanted Simon dead, so he had the Portuguese arrest him and deport him to Portugal. But on the plane, they attempted to throw him out into the Atlantic Ocean. But he stopped the plane mid-air using his supernatural powers. The plane resumed flight after they pleaded with him for mercy. To put this in historical context, in 1962, John Kennedy was the president of the United States. The civil rights movement was in full swing. Malcolm X made a famous speech on police brutality. Rosa Parks refused to give up her seat, and Cassius Clay was soon to become Muhammad Ali. When Simon arrived in Portugal in the presence of several doctors, they cut open his chest and pulled out his heart and took it away for tests. But Simeon awoke and asked why they were persecuting him and demanded his heart back. He died voluntarily on December 31, 1984, but his resurrected body was seen by a few people after that. He warned the authorities that he would be back, but this time there would be many of them, and they would not be able to stop them. Sounds like the 144,000 to me. The world has never heard the truth, but the 144,000 will teach the world. The princes of this world will desire to kill them, but will not be able to. The authority to teach God's word was never given to the Gentiles, and the coming of the invincible 144,000 of the 12 tribes of Jacob will be evidence of that.
Earth. all units. Officers require assistance. Central to all units. Officers require assistance.
Yo, watch him, yo.
Shall prosper, and every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment thou shalt condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord. Judah, thou art he whom thy brethren shall praise. Thy hand shall be in the neck of thine enemies. Thy father's children shall bow down before thee. Judah is a lion's whelp. From the prey, my son, thou art gone up. He stooped down. He couched as a lion. And as an old lion, who shall rouse him up? So shall they fear the name of the Lord from the west, and his glory from the rising of the sun. When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard against him. The portion of Jacob is not like them, for he is the former of all things, and Israel is the rod of his inheritance. The Lord of hosts is his name. Thou art my battle axe and weapons of war. For with thee will I break in pieces the nations, and with thee will I destroy kingdoms. And with thee will I break in pieces the horse and his rider. And with thee will I break in pieces the chariot and his rider. With thee also will I break in pieces man and woman. And with thee will I break in pieces old and young. And with thee will I break in pieces the young man and the maid. I will also break in pieces with thee the shepherd and his flock. And with thee will I break in pieces the husbandman and his yoke of oxen. And with thee will I break in pieces captains and rulers.
Hey, what did Magneto say? The humans and their guns, man. The fuck is a gun, man? Man, we're gonna shoot fire, man. We're gonna be like them comic books, man. We're gonna be straight out of a comic book, man. Real power, man. That's why those comic books resonate with Jake more than anyone else. Because it's in us, man. That power is really in us. It's like what the Lord can do. The Lord can basically lock that power, turn off that switch in you. But that power, we're princes of the power and the spirit, man. Our spirits are charged.
Yo, watch him, yo.